Hey guys, welcome back. Dreamweaver23 here, and today on the second part to getting started with programming your Sphero robot, we're actually going to be doing the square robot function, the square route. It's a simple function that really goes through and shows you how to do some of the basics with starting with the programming through Sphero edu. On the last video, we covered where to go to get the Sphero edu app. Once you get the program downloaded, either on your phone or if you go to the site and download the app for your computer, you'll come up and it'll come up with a program that looks like this, right? So this is the Sphero edu app. This is running on my Windows PC, and it has some different functionality, but it's the same setup as it is for the Chrome browser or for the website browser. You have your profile that you log in, your drive, your programs, all these different things. Down here on the bottom right, you'll see that it says connect to robot, so we'll want to connect to the robot. Connecting to your robot, I did cover that in the last video as well, but if you can plug your USB that's going through your charging cradle, if you plug that into your PC and you go to connect to robot, it'll actually have some listings for it. If you do not see your robot listed here, hit this back button and it will actually bring up choose a robot to connect to. So this will here can bring up the Sphero Bolt, the Spark Plus, the Sphero Mini, Ollie Darkside, BB-8, BB-9E, R2-D2, R2-Q5, and the Sphero Spark and the Sphero 2.0. With this one, we're actually gonna be connecting to the Sphero Bolt. So I'm gonna click the Sphero Bolt right here and SB-1E-9E. So, getting started, we're going to create our first program. We are in the Programs tab, My Programs, on the app. Create your first program. We're going to call this Test. We are going to be using the block programming setup because the block programming, I think, is the nicest one. You also do have the draw function. You have the text function. So it goes from the easiest to the most advanced, I guess, if you will. The text program is actually just writing JavaScript. Blocks goes through and definitely helps, and then drawing is actually drawing out like shapes, like, I wanted to make a square shape or a triangle shape, and that's how your robot will go. Choose compatible robots. The program that we're going to be making today, we can make compatible with every robot that's out there. Maybe not the Ollie, I'm not sure, but you could make it for all of these. I want it to go through for just my Bolt and my Mini because I have those back there. I could also make it for my R2-D2. So we're going to hit create, and this is what it looks like when you start up. And this is the same screen that you look at whenever you're looking at it on your phone or on a tablet. It will come up with this same screen on here. Looking across the bottom, you actually have your different program or your different functions set up by category. So movements, lights, sounds, controls, operators, comparators, sensors, communication, events, things like on collision or on landing or on free fall. It can do different things. And then you create your own variables and create your own functions. For this simple program, we're going to go back to movements. So we're starting off here. The roll function or the roll block code is set up with these three attributes on here, right? So we have roll 0 degrees. So obviously this is your heading at something speed for 0s. So if we click in here, we can go through and say this is your heading. We can control this to whatever we want it to be. For right now, I'm going to keep it at 0. The speed that we want, I'm going to go, let's go about 55. And you can actually do this up and down, or if you click on the number here, you can actually control this as well. So we're going to do 55. And we want it to move for 1 second, so we can click that in there. It does have a decimal place, so you can also go in increments of seconds, so you can do 1.1 if you wanted to. We'll leave that like this. All right, so with this program set up as it is, it's going to drive forward because we have that facing the correct way at a speed of 55 for 1.1 seconds. We're going to hit start. Ta-da! And it worked. So we're going to stop the program and we're gonna add to this. Let's start from the basics, right? So you can go through and duplicate this block. Now, if I were to go through and start this program with this block duplicated like this, it's not going to go through and do both of these functions because they're not connected, right? So this makes a program. This is no longer a part of the program. That's something that if you don't realize that, the first time you go through and try to mess with that, it's gonna throw you off. They have to be connected. So, doing this right here, we'll go through and make these a program. And so it would roll forward for 1.1 seconds at 55, and then it would roll forward at 1.1 seconds for 55 at speed of 55 again. So altogether it would roll for 2.2 seconds. If we go through and change these up though, let's go ahead and duplicate this a few times. So that way we can get these things connected. Now, one thing that we could do is drag a stop in here, right? So what we're wanting to do from the first start is I'm gonna make this more of a rectangle shape. But if I wanted to do that, I would do 1.8 seconds. I'll just do it for 2 seconds. So doing this, we're gonna wanna change the heading. We'll keep the speed the same for all of them because we don't want it to go too fast. I don't want it to fly off the table. But we're gonna change the heading to 90. And then this one to 180 because the heading is set from its initial point where we have it aimed. And then I actually would like to have a another one. So at the end of it, I'll have it to where the heading goes back to zero. So if we're to run this right now, we'll click start. And he fell off the table. Now we can stop and we can actually look at the script, the sensor data. And you can actually see what happened on there. But see how these edges are rounded and it's a lot more curved than square? That's something we don't want. We're actually trying to program a square. So if we go in here and add stop, let's see how that does. So we're going to go through and run this program again. Now, two things. One, that was a better turn on the first one. But then the second one, it was more of a curve, and we can actually see that through this sensor data. You can see this big loop that it did right here. And then it didn't even stop in the same place where it started. So that's bad. We don't want it to do that. Let's reduce this duration. Nope, not increase it to 21 seconds. We'll do it to 1.75. And instead of stops, I'm going to add these ones back in here. But I'm going to keep them with zero speed, and I'm gonna say for 0.5 seconds, right? All right, so adding these in here with the stopping spots to stay at the same degrees for half a second, I also did change it back to the coming back to our direction for 1.1 seconds as opposed to just doing it to the 0.9. But let's go ahead and test this and see how this works. So going up is good. Staying in frame as well. And that looks really good. Look, it looks like almost the same spot where it started. Let's look at the sensor data. And that is really close to where it started. So you can see this is a lot better square. You have those hard edges on the square. This one right here, a little soft, but all together, it stayed on the table, which is good, and it made our square shape. So a really good test for that one right there. Now you can get more complex with these. This is just one function that we really used, the roll function. We changed the speed and everything like that we wanted to have it at, but this is just the roll function. So this is a really nice function for it. It has a good set of programming. The programming blocks give a lot of ease of understanding for them with being able to click on different things. Right clicking, you can add comments to this block. You can do block help. Combines heading speed and duration to make the robot roll. Right? You can go to learn more. Got it. Good to go. So a lot of really good functionality in here. On the next one, we're going to be making a slightly more complicated system. Not complicated. A slightly more efficient system with using loops to go through and actually do the same functionality for us. So join me next time. Until then, this is Dream River 23 reminding you to game happy, and I will see you all later. Bye, guys.